Míralo que mi gente, bienvenidos a season 2, episode 2 of Teach Me How To, pero en español, míralo, look out, look at it, watch out, watch it, however you put that thing down, flip it and reverse it. Estoy muy emocionada que ustedes están aquí conmigo para aprendernos español. Okay, I got some nuevos amigos and some amigos regresados who are here to learn some vocabulary and grammar, and I'm so excited to do this journey with you all. There's little horses in my throat and my voice. So, no, I'm not sick, but I have allergies and they are trying to put a chica down. But regardless, we're going to keep on going and have a great day of learning. And while we are here, amigos, I want you to check out the referral link for my podcast. Click it. You will get to learn about authentic foreign language through TV shows, music, and movies. The application is called LingoPie. You can download it on your smartphone or tablet, or go onto the website on your laptop or PC. You'll be able to practice your listening skills, build vocabulary and grammar skills, and enjoy endless fun learning a language in específicamente español, amigos. So let's get into it, amigos. Let's begin with our word of the week, la palabra de la semana. Televisión. That is a cognate, and it's not a false one either, but televisión means television, okay? And then there are two other words that I'm going to share with you for those who may be like, oh, I heard this word before. Is there another word, like how in English we say TV? Well, you have televisión, which is realistically, like more so, not the actual mechanism, you know, the actual television. That is you watching television, right? Then you have televisor. That's the thing. Like if I were to go to Target, Walmart, Best Buy, or Amazon and buy a new television, I would say televisor. Not that you can't say televisión, but you know, just letting you know. And then the short version, which you might hear more commonly, especially in certain countries in Latin America, la tele. Okay, so you have televisión, televisor, and la tele. Next, we have the verb of the week. And I'm going to give you another verb that can be used occasionally for the same thing, depending on what you're trying to convey. And then I recently taught my level 4 reflexive pronouns. We'll go into the, you know, the science of grammar in the future, but for the language nerds, grammar nerds like myself, that's something you like to use to describe what someone looks like. So we'll get into that. So the verb of the week is ver. El verbo de semana es ver. Ver means to see. It means to see. It also can mean to look or to appear. But again, like that depends on phrasing and if I'm using a reflexive pronoun. But in general, the basic, ver means to see. Then you have another verb similar, mirar, which means to watch. Okay, like the title of this episode, míralo, look at it, you know, watch it, like look out, you know, míralo, like it can mean what you want it to mean, depending on the context of what you're trying to say, okay? And then the last version of ver, that's the reflexive pronoun, that's verse. It means to look or to appear, and that may mean for something like, if I want to say, you look cute today, or, oh, I was trying on this outfit, and I say, me veo bonita, like, I look cute in it, or I look or appear to be cute in it. So that's the verb of the week. And now we're going to get into the number of the week brought to you by my wonderful nephew, Julian, or Julian, but you know, for the sake of the episode, we'll call him Julian. You gotta say 12.
12.
And 12 means 12. Now let's get into the frases. So, first frase, la primera frase. ¿Miraste el programa Rebelde en 2004 en la televisión? Yo repito. Oye, ¿tú miraste el programa Rebelde en 2004 en la televisión? Did you watch the program or the show, the TV show, Rebelde or Rebel in 2004 in the television? Okay. Very simple, very easy way to practice using mirar. And then again, for those who love the grammar, okay, I use mirar in the past tense. Since this is season 2, you will likely begin to see some uses of the verbs for the verb of the week or the word of the week or even the number of the week, trying to practice our past tense, okay? Since we're in season two, you know, as we keep learning language and we just want to keep growing, we have to start using the more complex things. So let's get into the second one, going back into the present tense though, okay? All right, frase dos. Te ves muy bonita. Te ves muy bonita. You look very pretty. Or if you're talking to someone that is, you know, masculine, te ves bonito. Te ves muy bonito. Te ves bonitísimo or bonitísima. However you want to flip it. Te ves muy bonito or bonita. You look very pretty. Okay? That's a great way to have a conversation with someone who you find attractive and you might think you have a little something going on. I actually thought of this phrase. Well, I shouldn't say thought of it. A student the other day asked me how to tell a girl she looks pretty. And they were in Spanish too. So I was kind of like, why are you asking me this? You should know this already. But anyway, but yeah. So that's why I use that verb sentence, or use that sentence in that verb. So there you have that. And now for la tercera frase, frase tres, okay? Con el número de la semana, with the number of the week. Hace 2 días que comí carne. Hace 12 días. Que comí carne. Now, when I say this, I'm going to try and say it in 2 different ways so you can understand. So I use the verb hacer with this phrase because when you use hace que with a number, you're saying how long it's been since something occurred, okay, using the past tense. So it's like I said, it has been 12 days that I ate meat. But realistically, I'm saying it's been 12 days since I ate meat versus it has been 12 days that I ate meat. But yeah, so I ate meat 12 days ago. That's the gist of the sentence, okay? So let's go over them a couple more times. So frase uno, miraste el programa Verde en 2004 en la televisión. Frase dos, te ves muy bonita. Y frase tres, hace 2 días que comí carne, okay? So now that you have all of those frases, please make sure you practice them, okay? Don't forget to click the link of the week, language learning application Mango Languages. Very similar to Duolingo in the sense that you can pick a language. Here we're picking Espanol, and you're going to practice, and it has interactive different activities that you can do with listening, speaking, reading, and writing. But I will say one of my favorite features on this application is the speaking part, because it will allow you to practice the pronunciation way more accurately in some of the other applications I've seen before. So if, you know, for example, when I have Spanish 1 learners, they're like, ¿cómo te llamas? And I'm like, Lord, please help us, help us. So when you say ¿cómo te llamas? It'll say, that's not how they say that. They don't say it like that. And it forces you to practice to have a pronunciation that is more accurate. So you go from saying ¿cómo te llamas? To ¿cómo te llamas? Or, you know, depending on your region, ¿cómo te llamas? You know, I am going to Argentina this summer, so I'll hear a lot of zh and my double L's and my Y's. But yeah, it'll force you to practice your pronunciation. And I really, really like that because it kind of takes the gringo out of the gringo a little bit. Okay. Now let's get into our song of the week, Despacito por Luis Fonsi featuring Daddy Yankee. So I hope you take this time to enjoy a little snippet of this song.
Oh yeah, ya, ya me está gustando más de lo normal. Todos mis sentidos van pidiendo más. Esto hay que tomarlo sin ningún apuro. Despacito, quiero respirar tu cuello despacito. Deja que te diga cosas al oído para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito, quiero desnudarte a besos despacito. Firma las paredes de tu laberinto y hacer de tu cuerpo tu
Okay, amigos, terminaste, yo terminé, okay, you finished, I finished. This was a great episode with some grammar, vocab, and a little bit of past tense or el pretérito, if you want to be, again, like I said, those who love grammar like me. Okay, gracias, muchísimas gracias, un mil gracias que ustedes están conmigo para aprender español. Gracias, amigos. Thank you so much for spending today, this time with me to learn some español. Please don't forget your tarea. Read, write, and speak the verb, number, and word of the week. Memorize the three phrases. Record yourself saying them. Play it back to listen to it. Listen for cognates from the song of the week. Practice listening to the language using lyrics training from the song of the week. Okay? Don't forget to watch authentic foreign language TV shows and movies on Lingopie to practice your listening and building vocabulary and grammar skills. I have my referral link. Please click that to create an account and learn. And also, they now have integrated Netflix, okay? So that show I talked about, Reverde, earlier, you can now watch that show on Lingopie so you can learn how to use language in your everyday conversations, okay? And while you're using language in your everyday conversations, get that app, wordreference.com, to practice understanding new words you were exposed to. And for those who need a little bit of extra practice, sign up for my tutoring services, okay? Check out the informational flyer link, okay? And then for those who might want to get a little comfy cozy while they're listening to the podcast, click the link for some cool merch from Seek Jesus. I have me a really dope comfy hoodie, and I'm waiting to get it, and I cannot wait, so I have to let you know how this amazing quality hoodie makes me feel when I'm doing the podcast. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. Gracias, amigos. Hasta luego. Nos vemos. Oh, that was the other thing I forgot to use. You can use ver to say see you later, okay? So now you can say nos vemos. That means we see each other later, okay? Now, I know you can't physically see me, but that's okay. I got Instagram. I got TikTok. I got YouTube. I got Facebook, okay? So click the links, like, subscribe, share. Gracias, amigos. Ciao. And that's it.